Not many I trust. I'ma go my own way, God. Take my fate to wherever you want. I'm out here on my son. Won't stop till I get me some. Club hopping, trying to get me some. Bad bitches when they get me sprung. Early in the morning, I'm making bacon.
I think time lapses can be an extremely powerful tool, especially for videos. I mean, just for an example, let's take two different transitions for me arriving to the airport and getting to the hotel.
So that's one way you can move a video along, but you could also use a time lapse.
Thank the Lord for that burning bush, that big body Benz I was born to push. On my way, I'm burning kush. Nigga, don't be worried about us. Neighbors knocking on the door, asking, can we turn it down? I say, ain't no music on. She said, no, that weed is loud. Nigga, we ballin'. Trey swaggin', lost heart, but I'm maintaining. I've been told that I'm amazing. Make sure keep that fire.
This looks weird. How does this look? Does this look good? A part of me wants to say, like, this shot is like, I have like a chair behind me. I have things to pull up here. It makes sense in my brain, but maybe it just looks like super ass. Oh, man. It is 9:17 p.m. I just landed in Albuquerque, New Mexico. I'm here for business. I'm going to be here, obviously, tonight, all day tomorrow, and then I leave Thursday evening. Yeah, my flight takes off around like 7 p.m. I think that time lapses are a fantastic way to move along like a YouTube video or just in any kind of media. I mean, you see them everywhere. Choosing a right way to take a time lapse can really make or break kind of like the transition, the flow, and the scene itself. So I am still learning myself. I don't want to say I'm some time lapse expert. I'm not that great at cinematography. No way you're gonna blur right as I say that. That's illegal. I don't think I'm very good at, but I kind of wanted to test myself today, is time lapses. I use three main cameras, I guess technically four. I use a Canon M50 with the stock 15 to 55 millimeter lens. And then I also use a 750 to 300 millimeter. It's a very cheap lens, I'd highly recommend it. And then I use just a GoPro Mini 11. I also just have my iPhone 14, I think it is, with like the three cameras on it. So with those three cameras, I kind of wanted to, as I was traveling today, I was on a plane, I was in an airport, I was in downtown New Mexico, and there was a sunset, and at nighttime. There was basically about five different shots that I kind of want to take, kind of just encapsulate taking a time lapse with those three different cameras, and just to kind of show myself and also maybe provide you a little bit of better insight on what camera looks like. What the settings I used were honestly just kind of stock settings. The Canon M50 obviously has a lot more flexibility when it comes to how you're gonna choose your shot, where the time lapses, you have like three different scenes. If you want to use like people walking, if you want to use clouds moving, or if it's a really slow long scene. And you can also obviously change the lens. So it's. I feel like I don't want to just end this video saying what everyone already knows, that a mirrorless, more expensive camera is going to be the best way to take time lapses. Because I think the phone, it doesn't have as much flexibility. And if you're trying to zoom in more, it's not going to be obviously as great. But I think a phone time lapse is the most, I'm always the most pleased with it. So the first time lapse that I actually ended up taking was just in the airplane itself while we were flying. I basically would just put each camera on the window itself. It was a little bit tricky because with the iPhone it could sit in perfectly. I had to hold the GoPro and the Canon M50 a little awkwardly, so there might be a little bit of jittering, but I'm trying to keep it as even as possible. Throughout, as I explain what I took the shots and kind of my reasoning why, I just want to put up the shots themselves separated and then kind of all together, just to kind of give a quick general perspective of what each one is going to look like.
I need
was inside an airport with people moving like past the camera. A little bit quicker of a shot because in the airplane, obviously, you're moving very slow. And like, there's a couple different ways you can kind of go about it. But when there's people walking, if you do a time lapse too quick, I mean, it's just going to look awful. So that was more of a quicker people walking around past the camera. The next one I wanted to do was just basically zoom in each camera as much as I could. So I put the longer lens on the Canon M50. I zoomed in the iPhone all the way, and then the GoPro. The GoPro just, it was just there. I diagnose my damn self. These damn pills ain't working, fam. In my spare time, punching walls, fucking up my hand. I know that shit sounds super great, but if you had my life, you'd understand. But I can't fold. Some poor soul got it way worse. We're all troubled in the world in trouble. It's scary to have a kid walk this earth. And then I have, fortunately, a very great view of the sunset. So just kind of as you can see, like obviously all the orange and it sets, and you're gonna lose out on a lot of that that light coming in. Kind of how each camera reacted differently to that. Yes, I'm so odd. Think about all my old friends who want my friends all along. When it rains, it pours. Whiskey bottles on the sinks and floors. Every day the fight stays a chore. Mr. Dream with no exit doors. I need more. And then lastly, I just went back outside. I put it down and dirty again with fast-moving objects, but at nighttime. To kind of just provide a little bit of a general idea of what the scene's going to look like when it's a bit darker, because obviously filming with not as much light is going to be a little bit more difficult. Stock, just easy to set up time lapse. You could obviously take a time lapse very differently with just one camera. You could try to do like a long exposure to get a pretty unique shot. You could take one for hours at a time. You could do like the Milky Way. I mean, there's not a single way to do a time lapse, but I would imagine when most people are trying to kind of just figure out different details of it, they just want to see stock settings, different kind of scenes that just kind of encapsulate an entire kind of what you'll see generally. I didn't want to do something super specific, like take a 6-hour time lapse of the night sky. Like, if you want to do that, there's a lot of great videos that you can actually check up on, and I would actually like to learn myself. But I just wanted to provide a general introduction to time lapsing with three different styles of cameras that I think most people are always going to start out with when they're trying to introduce themselves to filmmaking. So yeah, I hope it gave you some kind of insight to what camera, how they look for different time lapses, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. I'm just what you make, I'm just what you make, I need it to get by,